How's it going, everybody? Welcome back to part 25 of our Persona 4 Golden playthrough. So last we left off, we are in Tatsumi Port Island, where the Persona 3 storyline takes place. We are visiting here on a field trip, and we just finished day one activities and are staying at a more than questionable hotel. But we are just finishing up day one and are going to proceed into the next couple days of the event. Day two of the school trip. In the afternoon, you toured Tatsumi Port Island. And at night, we went to the mall, Club Escapade.
Whoa! So this is a club!
Woo! I'm totally ready for this!
There's nothing like this back home.
Is it permitted for high school students such as yourselves to be here?
What? Dude, look who's talking. You were here before we were.
That's right. I guess if the first years came on the trip, you'd be here too.
The clientele here seems above board, so I don't expect there'll be any problems.
Huh? You're leaving?
Why don't you join us?
Are you asking me to stay?
Uh-huh. We didn't get to chat last time.
It's just that I had some matters to attend to that day.
Well, you're free now, right? I was really eager to talk to you. I'm curious how someone my age is working as a detective.
How about it?
Very well, if you insist.
Huh? What's up? You look a little red.
That's not true.
Wait here. I'll go reserve the area upstairs for us.
Okay. Wait, what? Reserve?
Yep. Don't worry. I think I can pull some strings.
What's wrong, man? Stomach pains?
That ain't it.
Oh, someone a little nervous? Risa reserved the second floor, and you all made a toast.
Are you sure this is all right?
Isn't it expensive? No worries. 2 years ago, when I had a secret show here, the power went out in the middle of it and the gig was canceled. They still owe me from then, so they're willing to put this one on the house.
Well, in that case, I'm gonna order more!
Woo! I'm not gonna hold back either!
Dude, you sound even weirder today.
Oh! You're so cold, Kanji. Kanji. I conjecture that something's up. That's a great one.
Man, you're already in high gear.
Conjecture?
She's looser than usual, too.
Hey, wait a sec. Are these liquor?
I told them to give us soft drinks. They're not alcoholic. I told them. Really, I did. Really.
Oh, sheesh. I was wondering why it's so hot.
Is this seriously booze? But the smells...
King's game! Times like this, adults play the king's game. It's the law. What's their problem? They make me act like a ditz, call me Rosette and stuff, and then say I'm a kid. It's so obvious. Those rap parties get a lot funner after I go home. Morons! I'm gonna play the king's game now, and ain't no one gonna stop me.
Yet another side of Risa exposed. I wonder if she knows what she's saying.
Kanji! Get the chopsticks ready.
What? Why me?
The king's word is law! Chop chop!
It's already started?
What's this king's game again?
Okay. One chopstick makes you the king if you draw it, and the others have numbers on them. The king picks the number and says what that person has to do. But who has which number is a secret until the king gives the orders.
Senpai, you're such an adult. You tell him.
Yukiko, where'd you learn this stuff?
Come on, everyone
Don't
draw.
Don't worry about it. What stick should you draw? We'll take the close one. I drew a stick. It says number 6.
Okay, so who's the king?
Teddy's is red. Red! Is Teddy the king?
We're already doomed from the get-go.
I, the king, command thee to smooch the king without delay. Smooch!
Smooch!
Please, God, grant me a girl. Number 3! Ah! I'm at number 2!
No take-backs!
Smooch! Smooch!
Kanji! So you were after my fuzzy fur!
Okay, but it's my first time. Be gentle.
Get him, Teddy!
Whoa! Ow! Wait, quit that! Don't make me find you, damn it! Ah! No! Hey! Help!
Ooh-hoo! Only the first round and two contestants have dropped out already. Huh? Is it that kind of game? On to round 2!
You must be very careful here. Which stick should you draw? Well, the near one didn't work, so let's take the far one. I drew a stick. There's a red mark on it! You're the next king!
Who's the king?
It's your boy.
Phew! Someone decent. No crazy orders this time.
That's not how it goes. If the last king demanded a smooch, then the next order's gotta be more extreme.
T.A., don't be such a party pooper. Hey! The person who gets picked should have to rest their head on the king's lap.
Nah, make him sit on his lap.
Oh, or they could have to hug him.
Better than that, a piggyback ride.
Come on, King, who's gonna do what?
Number 1 has to rest on my lap.
Yes, I'm number 1.
Pog.
What? Oh, man, you don't know how much I want to trade places with you right now.
Senpai's lap is so warm. It feels so nice.
Risei is lying there, completely relaxed.
Me next! Me! I'm the king! Actually, the queen.
You didn't even draw a chopstick!
All right, then. Let's have someone talk about something really embarrassing that they'd never want to tell anyone. Let's see. Oh, Naoto-kun, I choose you!
She's breaking all the rules. Just ignore her, Naoto.
No, that won't be necessary. One stipulation, though. If I do this, the rest of you must reveal something as well.
Okay.
No particularly embarrassing experiences come to mind. Would discussing my life be fair game? It's the rare situation like this that gives me call to speak of such things.
Damn, way to kill the mood.
The Shiragane family has been detectives for generations now. We lend our powers to the police from time to time.
For generations? Wow, it's like that guy from a movie I watched before. What was his name? Kuzu Noha?
In days gone by when there were no crime scene investigators, consulting detectives were considered more valuable. Thus, my grandfather still has a strong connection with the police and looks after me, despite my youth and inexperience. But investigators nowadays are well-versed in science and medicine, so I must further my studies.
That sounds tough. That's it? No punchline?
I fear you may be looking to the wrong person for that.
That's so embarrassing! Isn't Hotokun embarrassing?
I want to go home.
Oof, I'm sleepy.
Well then, it's your turn now. Straight answer, please. What is your true involvement with the murder case?
You know, you're so good at killing the mood that it's almost funny.
Well, we go rescuing people who've been kidnapped by jumping into the TV. And then we do stuff like Persona with our personas and beat the crap out of shadows.
You idiot!
Are you making fun of me?
It's true! Persona! Jeez, someone put these two drunks to bed already!
I see now that you had no intention of telling me the truth. But I'm curious, how did you become so inebriated? This isn't alcohol.
Good one, Naoto!
No, I confirmed it when I first entered. No alcohol has been served here since a rash of drunk driving last year.
Huh? Does that mean we're all just drunk off the atmosphere?
Who cares? I feel so good. Good night!
Hey, senpai! How the hell are we gonna get back with two passed out drunks?
All this is giving me a big headache. Is this what a hangover feels like?
Teddy's still totally okay. Let's keep drinking till morning.
Bring it on.
As I said, you haven't been drinking alcohol. Are you a pack of imbeciles?
Yes. The last night of the school trip drifts on. The third day of the school trip, we're at the shopping district at Hakakure Ramen.
Oh man, this is really something!
This place serves the best ramen in town. When we were filming, a lot of times I came here instead of eating box lunches. You're not hungry?
What happened last night? I don't remember much about it.
Oh, I think the two of us fell asleep quick. I heard it got pretty wild, though.
I see. I don't remember at all.
This flavor never changes. I couldn't come here too often because it's high in carbohydrates, so being able to eat as much as I want is like a dream.
Ooh, this is delicious. It has an interesting taste that makes you hungry for more.
See? See?
Another bowl, please. Keep the noodles hard.
I'll have the Hagakure bowl.
The Hagakure bowl's a normal menu item now? Oh, I should have asked. Well, this is just as good.
Hey, is it okay for you to be out in the open like this?
Sure, no prob. See those signing boards? My autograph's up there too, but the cook doesn't give me a second glance. That's just how it is over here. Plus, I'm barely wearing any makeup.
Oh, you're right. There's a lot of autographs on display.
You know what I think? The reason they don't notice you is because this bear sticks out like a sore thumb. I guess if he wore that over here, he'll have to go home wearing it.
Isn't it all steamy inside from the ramen?
Huh? Where's my bowl? You didn't eat it, did you?
You didn't finish, so...
Uh-oh, Teddy.
I was going to finish! bullshit!
Hey, didn't you just order more a second ago? How many have you eaten?
I don't know how to count.
You little liar, give me that check. Let's see here. 10 bowls?!
Yuki-chan's makes it 11!
I was going to finish mine.
There.
I'm sorry to interrupt, but it's close to the meeting time.
Oh, already? I thought the trip was going to be a bore, but now that it's over, I actually had a good time. Hey, let's buy a souvenir at the station. I bet Nanako-chan will be expecting one.
Let's see. She likes t-shirts. Let's get her a t-shirt.
All right, let's get going. Come on, Teddy. We're leaving. Yo. Hey, Ted.
Don't make me rub your fur the wrong way, you little... Dude! Hey, he ain't moving! Is he hibernating?
Hey... Don't tell me. It's not because he's been in our world too long, is it?
Are you serious? Teddy!
My tummy's heavy!
Damn it, Teddy.
Leave it behind.
I'm with Yukiko.
I ate too much. Can't move. Someone carry me.
I mustn't be late for our rendezvous. Please excuse me.
Oh, Yukiko, wait for me.
Hey, I really can't move. And I don't have the money for a return ticket.
Farewell, Teddy. We shall leave you here, along with our memories of youth.
You all headed back to the rendezvous point to head back home. All the days of the school trip passed by safely.
Welcome home. Did you have fun?
Yeah, it was great. You should come with next time.
Yep, for sure. I want to go to Destiny Sea, too. There's this roller coaster that goes whoosh into the water, and...
Nanako was talking about it happily. You remember that you brought a souvenir for Nanako.
Wow, thanks. Mm-hmm. Thanks.
Nanako thanked you out of modesty. Do you not like my t-shirt?
Dad.
Is it because it didn't have a platypus
back.
On it?
We just missed each other, huh?
Look, my big bro got me a souvenir.
Hey, nice. Did you remember to thank him?
Of course.
I guess that came out of your own pocket. Thanks. You went to Tatsumi Port Island, yeah? I guess the city was no big deal for a guy like you. By the way, if the first years went along with you, Naoto Shiragane must have been there too. You talked to him much?
Yeah, he hung out with us.
He's mature for his age, but he's still a year younger than you. Try to make friends with him, will you? He's a cocky brat. But he's honest. The higher-ups are losing their patience with him. It doesn't matter if his argument holds water or not. At this rate, he won't accomplish anything but getting himself booted off the team. Adults can be a selfish bunch.
Dojima has a kind look in his eyes.
Oh, sorry. You must be tired. Why don't you take a bath? Oh, but don't forget to take your stuff upstairs. Nanako, can you get the bath ready?
The school trip is over, and it's a peaceful Sunday morning. Nothing of note has happened while you were away. Cool. Let's see if there's anything worth buying on the shopping channel. Yeah, I could buy fish. Never know when that'll come in handy. And then today is a Sunday, so... well, first we're going to see what we can buy from her, and then we should be able to hang out with Marie and get her to rank 10. Yep, here she is. No, dang it, I clicked on the stupid velvet room. Oh, she's not ready to advance yet. Dang it, I was hoping I could get her to 10.
Oh!
Everyone's gonna show up and we're gonna hang out. Yay! Alright, so now hopefully she'll be ready to rank up. Today is Sunday, so there's no hospital. So it looks like it's another day for Courage. Alright, Courage is maxed out. Excellent. It's actually very good, because in order to eventually start a certain social link, we need to have max knowledge and max courage just to start it. So getting that stat maxed out now will help us tremendously in the long run.
I hope you all enjoyed the school trip. Don't you all feel just a bit more mature now that you've visited an urban area like that? Oh, by the way, that cute bear that Yukun had on the trip. It was really adorable. I get so tempted by animals with such unique designs. Speaking of bears, their friends, the pandas, are also really cute.
Panda!
Do you know what they used to be called in Japanese? They were called black and white bears, and divided color bears, a perfect description of how they look. The mixed colors, so exotic, yet so delightful. You need to do some exotic things to become adults anyway.
You listen to the lecture. Again, I don't know if I do. I don't know if that interests me. Okay, it's a cloudy day on a Monday. Denny, what are you doing? Oh, sailor uniforms, for sure.
Oh, hey, everyone.
You, me? Our relationship will not deepen today, but that's okay. Yeah, what is that chick reading on? She doesn't have anything in her hands! What are you reading? I think we kick her out of club. Alright, so Yumi's ready to rank up.
Welcome to Nightline's special Night Watch report. A suspect in the murders in Inaba was safely arrested recently. But what few people know is that the mastermind who brought him to justice was a high school detective. Tonight's report will focus on this detective prince, Naoto Shirogane, whose handsome looks are sweeping the nation. Thanks for being on the show.
No. The pleasure is all mine.
Naoto's on TV.
Oh, his uniform's the same as yours.
First, congratulations to you and the police for your recent arrest of the culprit. It was well known that there were a lot of mysteries surrounding this case, and you did a great job clearing them up.
I'd hesitate to say that the matter is cleared up as such. It's true that our suspect was behind Mr. Moraoka's unfortunate death, but when I cast my eye over the case as a whole, I detect a few things that seem out of place.
Oh? Like what?
Unfortunately, I cannot divulge details at this time, but this matter claimed the lives of 3 people. Hence, I believe even the smallest inconsistency must be investigated.
I see. I have to say, this is a surprise in light of the police's official statement. Now for our next segment, the Detective Prince's true identity, where Naoto-kun tells us a little bit about himself. Amazingly, the Detective Prince has solved a whopping 24 cases. 16 of them were...
There's a detective at your school? When I'm older, I'm gonna go to your school, too.
The breezy evening passes.
Hi, Senpai.
Yo.
Hey, did you see the show on TV last night? Naoto-kun was on.
That thing about the detective prince solving the case? Come on, we're the ones who actually caught the killer.
But the police were the ones who identified the suspect, and he was cooperating with them on it, right? So it's true that he helped solve the case.
I'm kind of surprised, though. I didn't think he was the type to go after the spotlight like that.
Good morning. I've been waiting for you all. There's something I needed to discuss with you regarding the case.
Discuss? Dude, we'll be late if we talk too long. Hey, where's your uniform?
Could you please indulge my current theory on the matter?
What is it?
First, as regards commonalities between the victims, all of them were kidnapped before they were murdered. The victims were all locals who had been the focus of recent media attention, becoming suddenly well-known. That is the most likely scenario. I don't believe there's anything intrinsically unique about the victims themselves. Haven't you all come to the same conclusion?
Yeah.
Then allow me to state my point. Will you admit that a number of you fit these identical circumstances? There was a long interval between the second and third deaths in this case. But after I applied the aforementioned criteria, I discovered several similar disappearances had taken place. Yukiko Amagi, Kanji Tatsumi, Risei Kujikawa. All of you disappeared shortly after being shown on TV. Either you escaped death somehow, or you faked your own disappearances in order to divert attention from yourselves. Since some of you had ties to the victims, there came a point where I suspected one of you must be the culprit.
You thought one of us was the killer? Oh, you can't be serious!
This was a prior theory, since discarded. Putting together everything I've learned until this moment, I believe exactly the opposite. You aren't the culprits. You may, in fact, be the only ones with the means to pursue the true perpetrator. Seen as a joining of forces between the rescued, everything falls into place. Of course, this is all speculation. There is, in fact, a flaw in the theory. It doesn't account for the third incident, Mr. Moraoka's murder. He has never been broadcast on television, and neither did he ever disappear. We must also consider the condition of his corpse. The first two victims are still listed with an unknown cause of death. But Mr. Moraoka died of an easily identifiable blunt force trauma to the occipital cranium. The police have not satisfactorily resolved this discrepancy, yet they are desperate to close the case. Further action will be necessary to obtain some sort of decisive evidence.
Further action? What do you mean?
Well, whatever the outcome, the evidence should come to light. You said something interesting to me not long ago.
Hey, where are you going?
This is not a game for me either.
Naoto-kun?
No snap. Yumi! Yeah, we'll hang out with Yumi today. she will rank up today. Alright, and then this chick is still reading invisible text. We are in Yumi's father's room at the hospital. The door was open, so I cautiously went in. Now, try speaking to him.
Can you hear me? Look, it's Yumi. She's come to see you today. It's your daughter.
Dad?
Yumi. Thank you. You are a kind girl, unlike your mother.
I'm not kind. Not at all. You are a kind girl. You're your parents' pride and joy. You may be a bit angry and have a harsh tongue, but I know that's because you're trying to protect yourself.
It's my fault. I'm sorry. I was so selfish. I caused you nothing but trouble. But seeing you at last, seeing you care for me, I'm such a lucky man. Yumi. Yumi. It took your mother and me many days to come up with your name. Your name means bear fruit because we wanted your life to be full of good things.
What good things have I ever had in my life? Only you know that. Because you see, Yumi, the good fruit of our own lives is you.
Mom?
Dad? No. You must keep breathing.
Dad! Dad!
You never gave me the chance to say it.
Dad, thank you for bringing me into this world.
You came. Dad died. I just don't know what's going on.
I'll be all right.
Thank you.
Yumi is trying to come to terms with what happened.
Yukun, please stay here a little longer.
Stay by my side.
You can feel that Yumi is relying on you to help her.
Oh. I'm supposed to talk to the doctor. I'm sorry. Goodbye. I'll see you at drama practice.
Bye then.
You said goodbye to Yumi and went home. And Yumi has such a good social link. I love her social link. It's so good. Oh, it's a clear night. So I'm actually going to go to the shrine and see if what's her nugget is there so I can give her this fish. Oh, she's not. Okay, well, that's fine. Let's see, what do we got here? Understanding. I'm trying to think, because I do need to top off my knowledge, but I know it'll get there naturally through school and other stuff. So I've still got a little bit of time left before I think that I need to have that done for the social link, but... So we're just going to boost some of our other stats that need increased. You overhear students talking.
Hey, did you see that show on TV? The one about the Detective Prince's secret identity? Naoto-kun is so cool. Yeah, he really does have it going on, doesn't he? He's really young to be a detective, too. He's cute, but he has this aura of mystery about him. That's cool, too. You think he'll be at school today?
It is raining today, so today seems like a great day to turn in the Fox Quest. I think this is rank 7 for the Fox. So the Fox is almost done. We've only got a handful more of quests to do. Yeah, that was rank 7. I know these last handful ones, these last handful of quests, though, they get pretty steep in terms of requirements. Oh, yeah, I got fish stuff. Okay, yeah, so it's going to make us watch the Midnight Channel tonight. It's been a while since it rained through the night like this. You should check out the Midnight Channel just in case. Sounds good to me. It's raining tonight. Will something appear on TV? Well, you know the drill. Turn the TV on. Check. Raining? Check. Feet clipping through the floor? Check. A silhouette appeared. The image is hazy. You can't tell who it is. But you feel like you've seen this person before somewhere.
Did you see that? Someone came on, right? Now that the killer's been caught... Do we still gotta worry about the Midnight Channel? But then, someone said the blurry image seemed like an advance notice. What exactly is the Midnight Channel anyway? Did it have anything to do with the murders? Ugh, this is so frustrating. Hey, what do you think? Did you recognize who appeared just now?
I think it was Naoto.
Naoto? Why would he show up on TV? Now that you mention it, I wonder what he thinks about the Midnight Channel. I don't get this at all. It's gonna keep nagging at me, I can tell. I'm sure the others saw it too, so let's get together tomorrow and talk about it. Night.
Yosuke hung up.
So, about the Midnight Channel last night.
I wonder who that was.
I talked to Teddy and he says no one's entered the other side.
Well, yeah, the killer's been caught.
Yeah.
Huh? What's up?
Come on, get with the program. You saw the TV last night, right?
So? It's got nothing to do with us. The killer's behind bars, man. You guys are overreacting. Yeah, that shit Naoto said didn't make any sense either. So there's no use getting all worked up about it.
Huh? Naoto-kun?
No, well, how do I put it?
What, were you out of it because you were still thinking about what Naoto said? So you're still hung up on all that stuff.
I ain't hung up on it.
It's okay, we all understand. Just don't go overboard, man.
You little... I said that's not it! I got stuff to do. I'm out of here.
Stop bringing that up, Yosuke. You know he doesn't think it's funny.
What? Did something happen between Kanji and Naoto-kun?
Well, that aside, is it me or does the town seem kind of strange lately? Everyone is in high spirits for some reason, and they all talk about other people, but never themselves.
Really? I don't think it's anything special. Now that the murder case is solved, people feel relaxed, that's all.
That's how society is. They all just want to get in on the latest trend. People get excited fast and lose interest even faster. It goes round and round. There's no underlying reason for it.
I don't know. It still seems a little too weird. It's like they're all afraid of something. Oh, sorry. I just had this feeling.
Huh.
It's gonna rain again tonight.
We should check the midnight channel just in case.
Oh, you're home!
Alright. Midnight channel check number two. It's raining tonight. Will something appear on TV? Midnight channel came on. It's an extremely clear image.
Good evening, everyone. I am the Detective Prince Naoto Shiragane. Welcome to Experiment of the Century, the Genome Project. I will be experimentor and experimentee both in a forbidden yet wonderful bodily alteration process. You shall witness my departure into a new realm, the moment of a new birth. From the chosen day forth, I shall walk a completely different path in life. And I will share this glorious occasion, this memorable day, with all of you! Do stay tuned.
That was definitely Naoto.
Hey, is that you, Senpai? Naoto was just... So, does this mean he was kidnapped? You said people only show up clearly on TV once they're thrown into that other world, right? Hell's going on! I thought we caught the damn killer!
Kanji is completely flustered. It's alright, let's talk about it tomorrow.
You're right. Sorry, I called out of the blue. Being a detective, solving cases, it ain't worth shit if he gets himself kidnapped. Damn, that idiot pisses me off. Anyways, let's get the gang together and meet first thing after school.
He decided to go to bed early. You overhear students talking. It's been raining for a few days, but I heard it's finally supposed to clear up this afternoon.
Really? Then I don't have to cancel my plans. You know that there's a holiday next week, right? I promised my girlfriend we'd go to Okina together. I was worried it might rain that day. Huh.
What? If that's the case, then I hope it never stops raining. Rain like a waterfall so his date gets canceled. Those guys are best friends. True friendship right there.
Last night on TV, that was Naoto-kun for sure.
What's the verdict, Teddy? Is he really in there?
I do smell someone.
It's just like before. Nothing's changed.
Like before. Of course! That's why Naoto-kun appeared on the news so suddenly. He said something didn't seem right and that he wasn't convinced. He also believed that the people who are kidnapped appear on TV first, remember?
Wait, you're saying... he's using himself as bait? we came to the same conclusion he did, about how people who become famous through TV would disappear. Could he be trying to prove the theory by using himself?
You mean he got kidnapped on purpose? That's crazy! He could be killed!
He said, "This is not a game for me either. It's all my fault. I'm the one that said that to him."
Idiot! Why the hell didn't he just tell us?
He knew we'd stop him if he did. Instead, he left us clues so we could figure it out and...
I know! That son of a...
But what about the killer the police are holding now? Mitsuo did kill King Moron, right?
Yeah, but that's all he did.
I get it now. I remember Naotokun mentioning this. He said it was strange that the police were able to identify the cause of Mr. Moraoka's death.
Then is King Moron the only one Mitsuo killed? That'd explain why there were no signs of King Moron being thrown into the TV. The killer didn't change his methods for King Moron. It just seemed that way because it was done by someone else.
Then whoever kidnapped Naotokun, that's the real killer?
But wait a sec. Didn't Mitsuo say he was the one behind it all? Why would he take the blame for someone else's crime? Isn't that weird? And they said on the news that the culprit confessed to the other murders too.
There's also something else that's been bothering me, but,
To hell with someone who's behind bars! If we don't get off our asses, that stupid Naoto's gonna die in there! We gotta go find him!
Someone's definitely in here. And the world seems to have grown larger.
That's amazing, Risei-chan. There's no way my nose can pick up that much. Shall I give you a massage?
Teddy?
Don't bother her.
It's the same as last time. I know he's here, but I can't tell where. I need something that'll help me understand him. I need some clues. Without that, I have no idea which way we should look.
Damn it! There's too much we don't know about that kid. But if we don't do something, he's gonna...
Hey, snap out of it! This is just like all the other times. Let's not panic, keep an eye on the weather, and do this like always. We'll save him no problem. First, we need to look for something that'll help us locate him.
I know. I wasn't panicking. We know he's over here. So all we gotta do is get him out.
I'm sorry I couldn't find him. All I need is some kind of hint to help me understand him better. Then I could find him for sure.
Seems you need more information about Naoto to make any progress. You should ask around about him. Alright, so there's quite a few steps involved in this one, and I don't remember these, so... I do have a step-by-step process pulled up on the side that I'm going to go through to make sure I hit everything, because I don't want to do what happened last time and accidentally miss something. So I need to talk to one of these people. I think it was her, right? Okay, and then... do this. And then... there should be a police officer here that we need to talk to. Yeah, right up here. All the way up here. Well, maybe we can't talk to him today? Yeah, because I need to talk to that cop dude. Okay, well, that did work. So now I think we can go back and talk to him again. Oops. Okay. Okay, so I think that's everything. The next and final person we need to talk to is another police officer that only shows up on Tuesdays, Thursdays, or Saturdays. So the earliest we could wrap this up would be tomorrow. So for today, because we're in like the investigation mode or whatever, we can't hang out with any of our like friends. But if there's any school social links up, we could do those. But doesn't look like there is. I should actually, before I forget, pick up the Fox Quest. And I think this is actually the quest that I needed to make sure I fed the cat for. Yep. I wish I didn't fear cats. But it still leaves us with really nothing to do today. So this one starts, I believe, with a dude here. Yeah. So this is why we needed to feed the cat, because until you feed the cat, it won't show up outside your house. And we need the cat outside the house because we need to bring the dude to the cat so that he can help overcome his fears. So next time he should be able to do it, and then the quest will be done. But I don't, like I was saying, I don't really know what to do today. I don't even think I can invite anybody to the movies. Yeah, I can't bring anyone here. Not that I would, it'd just be kind of a way to kill time. Get everyone's festival clothes, that's kind of cool. I'm saving because I want to get... I want to get Halloween costumes after Halloween rolls around. I guess we'll go fishing at the beach. Oh, I have to have a sea fishing rod? Whatever, I'll just do this. I don't even know what this does. We just stare out into the ocean. Oh, I guess it just gives a random persona on us a bonus skill. Interesting. All right, let's harvest our vegetables, and then we'll go ahead and round out the episode. It's a big-ass melon. Alrighty, so we will round out the episode here. We will finish gathering clues on Naoto next time, and then once we have all of the clues, we'll be able to go into the TV and do their dungeon. So, yeah, we will leave it here for today. Thank you guys so much for watching, and as always, I will see you in the next one.
Always do it on my own, so I gotta get through it. And the only thing I know is to love what I'm doing. Never give up, never slow, till I finally prove it. Never listen to the no's, I just wanna keep moving. Keep my head up when I act, head up, that's a fact. Never looking back, I'ma keep myself on track. Keep my head up, staying strong, always moving on. Feel I don't belong, tell my thoughts to move along.